was the day before Thanksgiving, and all through the trees, the fall leaves were spinning aloft in the breeze.
Nine children had boarded their school bus with friends and hopes that a field trip soon would begin.
Partners, everybody.
Yes, let's go see some turkeys.
Did you know there are 6 different species of wild turkeys in North America?
No. Did you know that they can run up to 25 miles an hour?
Tell me something I don't know.
Partners, everybody.
They sang the road through the autumn terrain, while millions of drumsticks danced in their brains.
Over rivers, through woods, with running and weeds, the school bus sailed on through the new fallen leaves.
Without a murmur, there was such a clatter, they can no more notice what was the matter.
Well, what that sound? Are you here already?
We're here. Scoot over so I can look out the window, too.
When what with the wandering eyes, should they see but a miniature farm with 9 turkeys.
And a little old man, so lively and rugged, they knew in a moment it was Farmer MacNugget.
Welcome to my farm, kiddos. Watch your step getting off that bus.
He was dressed all in denim from his head to his toe with a pinch of polyester and a dash of Velcro.
And then in a twinkle they heard in the shrub the prancing and pawing of each little clock.
More rapid than chickens, his cockles as they came, he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Molly, now Stanley, now Julie and Mo, on Wally, on Beaver, on Shrimp and Groucho. Oh yeah, and Bob. These fellows over here are called gobblers. A gobbler is a male turkey, and these ladies over here are called hens.
Which are female turkeys, and baby turkeys are called poults.
You sure know a lot, little one.
Too much if you ask me.
The turkeys were chunky with smiley big faces. They greeted the children with downy embraces.
They looked different from the pictures in the books.
These farmer turkeys are different from the wild turkeys we looked up on the internet. Aren't they?
Take a look around and enjoy the farm, boys and girls.
This is cool. Hey, look at them go. 25 miles an hour. How fast is their flying?
55 miles an hour, I believe.
Are you serious? That's the fast my daddy drives on his fast roads.
Then somebody spotted an axe by the door. He asked Farmer Nugget what it was for.
Why do you have an axe here? Do you also chop wood too?
Uh-oh, don't tell me.
With a blink of his eye and a twist of his head, the old farmer told Grim Tail of Death.
Good night,
said Farmer MacNugget.
These feathery beasts will be chopped up and roasted for Thanksgiving feast.
The children stood still as tears filled their eyes. They clamored a leg in a chorus of cries.
These turkeys, these helpless, harmless birds?
I mean, say it isn't so.
Is it true? Is there anything we can do to stop this?
Oh dear,
cried MacNugget.
Now what shall we do? Let's get these kiddos some water.
So he dashed to the boat and the teacher went too. And they fetched some water fresh from the ground and all flooded one went for
everybody just put on their sweaters and jackets or something?
The boys and the girls drank up their drinks in the hay, then thanked Old McNugget and waddled away.
They looked at the school bus all huffing and puffing. It's not easy to walk with hot turkeys touching.
Thanks, Old McNugget. It was fun.
Hurry up before he finds out.
And then as the school bus drove up in the night, McNugget looked around, not a turkey in sight.
There's no compass.
Now how do we explain this to our parents?
Was the night before Thanksgiving and the stars up above shone down on a school bus bounding with love.
The very next evening, my families were blessed with 9 fluffy Thanksgiving turkeys as guests.
They feast on veggies with cherry and toast, and everyone was thankful for the turkeys the most.
For each one gave thanks for love and for living.
And they all had a wonderful, happy Thanksgiving.
Take a bow.